Our Rise Above campaign is all about celebrating the human spirit and rising above life's tough challenges. The Rise Above series features a collection of stories of everyday people doing incredible things right here in our own backyard. Today, we meet a Fresno mom who suffered a heart attack out of the blue at only 28 years old. And since then, she's been fighting for her health to spend more time with her family and helping to raise awareness to heart disease. Michelle Giannetta shows us what it means to rise above.
We asked you to share your stories overcoming life's challenges to rise above. Here's one inspiring story.
Soccer coach and Fresno mom Michelle Giannetta had a heart attack at only 28 years old. A huge shock.
Because I'd done everything right. I exercised, I ate properly, I didn't smoke.
Michelle had a failing heart, and her heart broke with the thought that she wouldn't be around to see her two sons grow up. But Michelle was determined to stay in the game, undergoing triple bypass surgery and wearing a heart pump daily. Anything to stick around for her family.
Because nothing is a given. You don't know what tomorrow's gonna bring.
Michelle is currently on the wait list for a heart transplant, always fighting for more time.
I appreciate the days when I can go out and coach soccer. I appreciate the time where I can take a walk with my husband.
Proving that every moment is precious, Michelle Giannetta inspires us all to rise above.
Share your stories with us now at riseabove.net and keep choosing to rise above.
And joining me now is the woman herself, Michelle Giannetta. Great to see you again.
Good to see you.
Your story, I think, strikes so many people in that you just were so young when you had your first heart condition, correct?
Correct. I was 28 years old when I woke up not feeling well one night, and we went to the emergency room and found out that I was having essentially a heart attack.
And you were so healthy. You didn't smoke. You didn't drink. I mean, you had no family history.
No. We did everything right. They've since done genetic testing and things like that and have been able to come up with no reason for it to have happened.
Wow. So what did that teach you about yourself and just appreciating your health?
My kids were young, and the thought that night when we drove to the emergency room that I might never see them again because I had no idea what was going on kind of puts life into perspective for you. As you take every day for granted, you figure you're going to wake up tomorrow morning and, you know, it'll go on the same as it did today.
Yeah.
And we've actually, over the course of the past 20 years, have had four different scares where I shouldn't be sitting here with you today.
Wow.
So it's just, you appreciate life and what it's got.
Well, you just give me goosebumps because I'm so glad you're here. And I know you make it a point to share your story, especially with women. Can you talk about your work with Go Red and the American Heart Association?
The American Heart Association started a program, and it was about 15, 16 years ago, called Go Red for Women. And what they had found that seemed to be unnoticed was that actually more women than men die from heart disease. And heart disease is the number one killer. And so they figured they needed to gear something towards women. Well, that was right up my alley as far as obviously being a woman and having heart disease, because we found out later on, after I'd been in the hospital a couple weeks, that women my age don't suspect women of having a heart attack, let alone heart disease. It's an unsuspecting thing. And so at that time, we really found out that I was lucky that the emergency room doctor recognized what was going on, because most women that I've met during the early years would have been sent home with, oh, you're having gas pains or indigestion or something like that, acid reflux, and then kind of sent on their way. Had that happened, I wouldn't have been up the next day.
Well, I know you've educated so many folks, and I know you're one of the co-founders of the Go Red for Women luncheon here in town. Is that just so inspiring to talk to these women and tell them your story?
It's amazing to see the numbers. The first luncheon we did, we had 150 people. Now we're up to like 400, 500 people.
Wow.
And it's actually true women. The first one was kind of geared toward the medical group. You know, doctors were there, people that were really tied in with one of the hospitals here locally. And now you have businesses that are trying to educate their employees and staff.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got businesses that'll purchase a table and send 10 women from their bank or from their business to go and attend. And it's heartwarming to see the number of women that are trying to find out and want to know more.
Yeah.
But then it's scary when you hear some of the stories that go on at the luncheon with women who had no idea, who'd ever, you know, thought that they had, even if they had a history of heart disease.
Yeah.
You know, cancer was what their concern was, and then they realized, wait a minute, I got something even bigger
that I need
to worry about, and it's a little more undetectable sometimes.
Yes, and it's amazing that 20 years ago, women didn't know it was the number one killer of women, and now, due to yourself and just so many others out there, thankfully, that's on the top of our brains, and we're looking out for it. So speaking of hearts, tell us about, you are currently on a heart waiting transplant, a heart transplant list.
Correct. We had the last scare we really had was just over 3 years ago. And my husband ended up doing CPR on me one night because I'd fallen through the table and fallen to the floor. And so that was when we'd been working with Stanford for about the previous 10 years. And we went up to see the doctor right after that. And he's like, okay, now it's not a matter of when, it's a matter of, it wasn't a matter of if, it was a matter of when. And he goes, and now is the when.
Yeah.
He says, we have to get you in and get you worked up. So we did, but as we were finishing the last day of workup, he came in and he said, I can't let you go home. And it's like, excuse me, I'm planning to go back to Fresno today because we were up at Stanford. And he says, I can't let you go home. He goes, your heart is not functioning properly. Oh. I had a pacemaker. My pacemaker could not read the waves and things that were going on. So he says, we have to keep you here. And a couple days later, he came in and he's like, you have a high antibody level and you're O positive, so it's going to make it really hard to transplant unless we can get those antibodies down. So he says, what we're going to do is we're going to put in a pump, basically, is what it is. So a couple days later, they went in and they put in a heart pump that is inside, so it's constantly with me.
Yeah, so that's the
that's what this is.
The little fanny pack that you
exactly.
wear.
Exactly, I'm not bringing the fanny pack in style, Stephanie.
Even though it is in style, but that is literally pumping your heart, helping to pump your
heart.
There
is. There's a pump that's here, and it comes, it actually comes out my side here and connects. It's attached
to this wire. And I know you manage it every day, and it's a lot of work, and I think it helps remind people to appreciate their health because you never know if you're going to have to wear a pump or just fight for your health like you are.
Exactly. This has become just a normal everyday part of life, but it's not easy in that I can't run in and take a quick shower and, you know, we're out the door in 10 minutes. I can't go to the pool. I can't go to the ocean, or I can't go in the ocean. My husband seems to think I will, like, fall in the water, you know, walking along the sand. So, you know, there are things like that because it can't be in water, so you can't take a bath. You can't go in a jacuzzi. But there are things that you can, I can now do and enjoy. You know, I coach soccer, and so I'm able to do that. I work full-time. I've got the other things in life that far and exceed make up for what I don't have.
Well, and I know you're a great mom and a great wife and just a great role model for all of us to think about our heart health. And so we certainly hope you get your heart transplant soon.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for sharing your story and helping us inspire others. It means a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks, Michelle. And don't forget, folks, our Rise Above series highlights local people right here in our own community who have risen above life's tough times. If you know someone who shows what it means to rise above, you can head over to the website riseabove.net to nominate them and learn more.